Today, I'm going to show you how to create a personal macro workbook. If you're at this video, there's a good chance that you were watching another YouTube video and it gave you code to add to the personal macro workbook and said, if you don't have Personal.XLSB yet, to come here to this video and watch, right? So first question, do you have Personal.XLSB? And we do that with Alt F8. And then here in macros and open it and see if in the list of open workbooks is personal.xlsb. If you do, then that's great. Go back to the other video and just paste the code in. But let's assume you don't. You don't have personal.xlsb. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to come out to the view tab. On the far right hand side is macros, and we're going to record a macro. For the macro name, we're just going to call it hello. And store macros in. This is really important. You open that drop down and choose Personal Macro Workbook. This is a starter macro to create personal.xlsb. You don't have to put that in, but it'll help you 5 years from now remember what the heck the hello macro was for. Click OK. Just select any cell. Probably A1 would be the right cell to select. Type the word hello and press enter like that. All right, so now the macro recorder just recorded the action of typing hello in A1. Look down here in the status bar beneath all the sheet tabs, to the right of workbook statistics is this little square dot. A macro is currently recording. Click to stop recording. All right, that's it. Congratulations. You have a personal XLSB now. Now, the problem that we have is you're going to continue to work in Excel for another 8, 10, 12 hours today. At the end of the day, you're going to close Excel and it's going to ask you, do you want to save personal.xlsb? And you will not even remember that you set up a personal XLSB, right? So, two options. One option is close Excel and let them ask you the question right now. The other option is a little bit harder, but not that much harder. Come up here into the ribbon, right click, and say customize the ribbon. And on the far right hand side, go to the developer tab and turn that on. If you've never had a personal XLSB, this probably isn't turned on for you. Click OK. Once you have the developer tab, then over here on the far left-hand icon, Visual Basic, all right? And if you've never been here before, this is gonna start completely blank like that. How intimidating. Go to View and Project Explorer, and then through this list, find personal.xlsb and click on it like that. Just a single click, not a double click. And with Personal XLSB selected up here, click Save, and that will save your macro with probably just Module 1 with that code. Code that probably looks like this, although in your case, it'll be in Module 1. Every time that you record a new macro on a new day, it'll go to a new module, and that's okay. These can all be in separate modules, not a big deal there. All right, well good, thanks for watching this video and go back to the original video where I have something very cool for you to add to your personal macro workbook. Thanks for stopping by, we'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.